Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome. Welcome to this time and this place and this space of worship. Welcome to this, the Sunday in which this is All Saints Sunday, the day in which we celebrate and remember the cloud of witnesses who have gone on before us, and we celebrate and remember those who have passed within the last 12 months from our congregation and from our community that we celebrate today. Today is a day for taking time, taking a moment to pause and give thanksgiving. So this is our time. This is our place. This is our space of worship. We belong here. We belong here together. And as we gather to share in this time of worship, let us pause to remember that we worship on lands that are by law the unceded lands in Mi'kma'ki, the ancestral territory of the Mi'kmaq people. May we live with respect on this land and live in peace and friendship with its people. Our announcements. Oh, I'm not on. I was like, I don't sound the same. I still don't sound the same. Hello. Hey, here I am. You heard enough, right? I don't want to do that again. Okay, cool. Our announcements are in the bulletin. They have been sent out by email or on Facebook. There's lots of places for us to get this information. So let's look at the week ahead. We have worship today, right now, and online. We have Quilters in the Parlor on Tuesday, Wednesday. On Thursday, the church office is open. And on Friday, we're making desserts at 9 a.m. and peeling vegetables in the hall at 6:30 p.m. And if you are able to help out with the preparations for the Congregational Christmas Turkey Dinner, please sign the sheet in the narthex. That would be very much appreciated. It takes many hands, many times in community, many volunteer hours to make this wonderful dinner happen, which I'm really looking forward to. So thank you to everyone who has already signed up to help. Thank you to all those who are already helping, and thank you to you who just thought, hey, I'm going to help too. I really appreciate it. A donation has been made to the Roof Fund in order of, in honor of Grandma by Connor and Sawyer Raleigh. Thank you to all for your support for our annual congregational craft and pantry sale at the Pictou County Arts and Crafts Sale yesterday. I have more information about that. Where's that piece of paper? Here it is. Anyone who missed the sale yesterday will have an opportunity to view the crafts in the parlor as they come to pick up your turkey dinners. So as you come to pick up your turkey dinners, the craft tables will still be up, and there'll be all good stuff to look at, and as well as our cookbooks, some angels, and some United Church Camp calendars for 2023. They'll also be available. Which brings me to our cookbooks. Our cookbooks are done. Yay! Yay, it's so exciting, and they're so good, and everything looks so yummy. And when you're putting together and reading all these recipes, it really makes you hungry, and which is what our fundraising committee decided. We need to bring more food to fundraising committee meetings if we're going to be reading recipes all the time. It's all good. The other great thing about these recipes is like they come with like hints from people, and they also come with the name. So like I'm just looking at one right now, date squares from Janice Guthrow. Hey, if I run and I'm making the date squares and I'm like, does she really need 375? I'm just gonna call Janice. No, she's joking. But it's like it comes with its own helper with every recipe. So it's really good. And they're all very yummy and delicious. So if you want one of these cookbooks, they'll be for sale at this when we pick up our dinners, and also you can get them from the office, or probably anyone from the fundraising committee can direct you to get one, how to get one. They're $20. So, thank you. What else is going on? Oh, and then I have this. Also a note. So, thank you to those who contributed by donating items, help setting up, and working at the sale, the pantry sale yesterday, with your help. This was a very successful event, and wow, was it ever, from the pantry table, the craft table, and the quilt ticket sales all together, realized $1,755.
Wow.
Wow. Good job.
Okay. Continuing on. Advance notices. Next Sunday is our Remembrance Day service. So we have our Remembrance Day Sunday service in the week leading up to Remembrance Day. So it'll be next Sunday. We have Bible study on Tuesday. Also, there's a Victor County Council of Churches meeting on Tuesday. I'm just looking for the rep. Christian education meeting is on the 9th. And then a lot of stuff starts happening after that. November 13th, we're going to start gathering for MSPJs. And November 27th is St. Andrew's Sunday. And it's Wear a Kilt Sunday, or whatever makes you happy. And I'm excited for this. I want people to wear whatever makes them happy. I think I'm going to have costume changes, because I have several outfits that make me very happy. So I don't recommend that maybe for everybody. That might make it quite busy at church, but wear whatever makes you happy. I'm hoping for hats or whatever. The sky's the limit. So maybe a dinosaur costume. I don't care. So, and then on White Gift Mittentry, I just want to note this for those of you who are preparing and looking ahead to White Gift Mittentry. I know I was yesterday at the craft sale looking at the mittens and everything for sale. We're inviting people to also include on our White Gift Mittentry Sunday pants, underwear, along with the mittens, because these are things that we, and socks, for both boys and girls, sizes 5 to 8. We've heard from the schools, and in addition to mittens, this is a great thing for them to have on hand. So some pants, some underwear, and some socks, in addition to the mittens, for sizes 5 through 8. So just keep that in mind as you're shopping for those events. Tickets for the Christmas turkey takeout dinner are now available. That's happening next Saturday, November 5th, and the tickets are $15, and they are a yummy, yummy dinner with all the fixings and a dessert. You can get the tickets from Evie or Nina. And if you don't know who Evie or Nina are, just ask me or ask someone, and they'll point you in the right direction. The deadline is Wednesday this week if you're dropping your items here for the Coats for Kids. So you can. There's also other locations to drop off Coats for Kids for that drive, but we can drop them off here too up till this Wednesday. The focus is on providing winter apparel for children, but they'll accept donations for all ages. So go through your closets, see what you have. They need to have working zippers. And they also are welcoming warm winter accessories, and all of the other drop-off places are listed there. There's information there for the food bank. There is information there for Viola's place. They're looking for backpacks. So as you're cleaning your closets, looking for coats and whatnot, have a look around for some backpacks and drop them off in the narthex. We've got a couple of baskets there for these drop-offs. Okay. The other side. There's information there about an advanced care planning, personal directive, community event happening at the library. Please have a read of that. There's a financial update there. Please have a read of that. There's an event happening with Region 15 called A Living Faith Story. And there's a poster on the back door there that you can have a look at to find out more information about all of those things. I have a birthday, but is there anything else coming for the community at this time? I have a birthday, but I don't see her. Where's Pamela? Oh, hi, Pamela! Did you go all the way back there every day? Did you want to remember your birthday? No, I don't. Is there any other birthdays today? Or this week? Actually, Pamela's was yesterday. So happy birthday, Pamela! Thank you. Marion unit is meeting Tuesday at 2.
Thank you.
Is there anything else? Wonderful. Then let us join together in our call to worship.
We are not alone. We live in God's world. We believe in God who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God. We are called to be the church, to celebrate God's presence, to live with respect in creation, to love
through death. We celebrate that they are in your presence, O God. We continue to miss them here with us. Today, we remember that we are connected with all of God's people and with all of Christ's disciples throughout history, those who have already lived, those who are living now, and those who are yet to be born. We are all that great cloud of witnesses who can never be separated from your love, God. Help us to remember them in this hour and honor the love they gave and received, the way they revealed your love, O God, to the world. Their love is part of your never-ending love, and just as your love is present with us, God, their love is present too. Amen. Now let us pause to remember the saints who have passed from our midst in the last 12 months, as well as those that we are remembering here at the table. Let us remember. Lindsay Denoon.
seek to offer support and care, healing and hope to those who feel these losses. Strong and tender God and Jesus, you share the joy and sorrow of this life, and so we pray also today for all others who know suffering and pain. Grant us all a vision of your purpose in our life and work together, that we may bear witness to the hope which is in Jesus Christ, in life and death, and life beyond death. Amen.
Our offering. Our offering has been gathered. Our offering has been received in all the many different ways in which we continue to support and sustain this important ministry. Let us take a moment to pause as we receive our offering. Let us take a moment to pause and offer a prayer for wholeness and renewal. Let us pray. O God, too often we have failed to heed the leadership of the saints who have gone before us. We keep living as if we know all the answers. Your forgiveness, God, offers us time to reflect on the ways in which we've missed the point of our faith. Reveal to us the courage we already have to be more than we have allowed ourselves to be for the cause of your kingdom. Forgive us, God, and help us to walk closer with you. Hear these words of assurance. The mercy and unconditional love of God permeates our lives. God's forgiveness is offered without exception. Let us now live as people who know this forgiveness, and all of the people say, thanks be to God. Amen and amen. Our opening hymn is appropriate for the day in which we celebrate the saints who have gone on before us as we sing When the Saints Go Marching In.
Oh, want from me and from you? What does Jesus want from us? What is Jesus asking us for? Right on. Love. How do we do that? What do we do that shows love?
Show kindness to people.
Show kindness to people. Very good. You have another one? What?
Ask for a hug.
Ask for a hug. That's very nice and sweet. Very good. Give help to somebody who needs it. This is all excellent stuff. So like kindness and generosity and all those good things. Oh, I love it. You guys are so smart. You've been listening to what Jesus has been asking from us. I love it. What's coming up Monday? Anything?
What?
Halloween! What are we going to do on Halloween? We're going to go trick or treating.
Yeah.
And what do we do when we go trick or treating? Dress up? And get into a costume we like, a happy costume we like. And then do we go to people's houses?
Yes.
Yes. And what, sorry? No. What can people do at the house? Have you ever been on the other side of the door? Have you ever been there when trick-or-treaters come to the door?
Yeah.
Yeah? What happens on this side?
We give them candy.
That's right. That's right. And so they come to the door. And you open the door, and what happens? What's the transaction here? They say,
trick or treat.
And then what do you do?
You give
them candy.
Give them candy?
And we're going to stay on the nice side of the store for now. and then they say, what do people say after they get candy?
Thank you.
On the internet, which ties those two concepts together. And I love it, so I'm going to read it to you. It says, Halloween is a day when we get it right. Strangers come to us, and those strangers come, they're beautiful, they're ugly, they're old, they're scary, they're in costumes, right? Odd? Oh, well, they could look old too if they're dressed up like an old person. The only costume we had growing up was dressing up like a granny. That was like the staple costume. Halloween, after school, come home, what are you going to be? I don't know, ghost? Old person.
Anyway.
On. And we accept them all, no question. We compliment them. We say, well, what a beautiful costume you have on. We treat them kindly, and we give them good things. We all should be living like that. That's what Jesus, right, is asking us to do, is to be kind and to give good things in the world. And so, think about that on Halloween, how this is an example of us living in community, sharing our resources, offering kindness to one another. It's a beautiful thing. Have a super fun, happy Halloween, and I hope we get lots of treats. And I hope you enjoy them all. So let's have a little prayer before we get upstairs. It's a repeat after me prayer. And we're going to put our hands together. Like this. Okay? Let's pray.
Thank you, God,
for showing us kindness.
Help us
to show kindness to the world.
Amen.
Good job, guys. So we're reading from the Gospel of Luke.
chapter 6. So things are just kind of getting rolling. And it's before, there's this long middle section in the Gospel of Luke. It's called this long journey section where Jesus is traveling from Galilee to Jerusalem. This is before that. This is early in Jesus' ministry. He has been doing lots of ministry. He's been welcoming people, and it's people who are on the fringes or outside of society. People who are odd, who have been misplaced by the society, who are not welcomed. And so he has been welcoming them and healing them and offering ministry to them and bringing them in the fold. In addition to that, he's gathered a whole bunch of disciples. There's like hundreds and hundreds of people that are following along with Jesus. We only usually hear about the 12. The 12 are now named just before where I'm reading as the apostles, so the emissaries. But everybody else, we're all the disciples, we're the students, we're learning. And so Jesus decides to take this moment, before they start their long journey, to do a big teaching to the group. And so he's teaching them what we now call the Beatitudes. When I was a little girl, the Beatitudes, I remember my Sunday school teacher. I will never forget this. Sunday school teachers have an amazing influence on our lives that we carry with us for the rest of our lives. Anyway, her lesson that day was about the Beatitudes, and she was drawing the connection that these are really friendly, and they're very helpful, and they're so good in the world, and that bees provide honey, and they pollinate the flowers, and they don't sting you unless they have to. So they're really good things in the world. So we want to have bee attitudes, and be like the bees. So I think of that every time. That was completely an aside. Okay. So these are the Beatitudes. As Jesus is preaching them, this is called the Sermon on the Plain, and let's listen to what sort of the core teaching of Jesus is here. He's kind of giving the nuts and bolts of what it means to be a Christian, what it means to follow Jesus. So Jesus says, as he looks across the faces of all of the disciples gathered, so think more than 12, think hundreds. All you who are poor, Jesus said, you are blessed. For the kingdom of God belongs to you, and all you who are hungry now, you are blessed. For your hunger will be satisfied. All you who weep now, you are blessed, for you shall laugh. When people hate you, when they exclude you, when they insult you, when they write you off as evil on account of the Son of Man, you are blessed. When these things happen, rejoice, jump for joy. Then you'll have a great reward in heaven, for at that moment you are experiencing what the ancient prophets did when they were similarly treated by the ancestors of your detractors. All you who are rich now, you are in danger, for you have received your comfort in full. All you who are full now, you are in danger, for you shall be hungry. All you who laugh now, you are in danger, for you shall grieve and cry. And when everyone speaks well of you, you are in danger, for the ancestors spoke well of the false prophets too. If you're listening, here's my message. Keep loving your enemies no matter what they do. Keep doing good to those who hate you. Keep speaking blessings on those who curse you. Keep praying for those who mistreat you. If someone strikes you on one cheek, offer the other cheek too. If someone steals your coat, offer him your shirt too. If someone begs off from you, give to them. If someone robs you of your valuables, don't demand them back. Think of the kindness you wish others would show to you, and do the same for them. This is our teaching according to the Gospel of Luke. Thanks be to God. Our next hymn is When the Roll is Called Up Yonder.
Thank you.
Spirit of God, descend upon us, making our hearts an altar in your love the flame. Amen.
So today is the Sunday. So All Saints Day is November 1st. But we have All Saints Sunday, the Sunday before November 1st. And so this is the day which we celebrate the saints. We celebrate the cloud of witnesses. And so on today, the lectionary scripture that they gave us is this Sermon on the Plain, the Beatitudes. And it is this scripture from Luke that is the summary sermon by Jesus, where he is offering these teachings, these blessings and warnings for people that are listening. And we wonder, what does it mean? Because it sounds like he is saying that some people are going to, you know, get blessings, and some people you already got all you're getting, you're not getting any more. That's kind of what it sounds like. And so, in order to get what's going on here, we need to know what it means to be blessed. Because the word blessed has been used in our English language a lot for a lot of different things. People usually mean it, they should be saying, I'm so fortunate. And they say, I'm so blessed. So, or they could say, I'm so lucky. But they use that same idea of being fortunate or being lucky and say that they're being blessed, that they're getting a prize for being so good. And that's not what blessing means. Blessing means less about something you get, more about something you're supposed to do. Blessing is an extension. So a blessing is an extension of God's grace. Blessing is an extension of God's presence in the world, as seen by those who reflect this blessing. Blessing means that you're reflecting God's love in the world. So when we receive a blessing, we receive the ability to be an extension of God's grace in the world. Does that make sense? So when we are blessed, when we feel we are blessed, or when God is blessing the poor, right? In the first thing is, blessed are those who are poor. You are blessed, for the kingdom of God belongs to you. You are blessed because God's love and compassion and grace can be seen reflected when the world sees the humanity in all those who are poor. And it's not just financially poor. The word poor means so much more that Jesus is using here. Our English translation is poor. Our English translation doesn't reflect it very well. It's anyone who is outside of society, anyone who is ostracized, anyone who is held back, anyone who feels that the main group of society is against them, anyone who is in that category is what this word means, this word poor means. And so we see God's love, God's grace, God's compassion reflected when we show compassion and love and grace to people who feel outside of it. And that's what the blessing of the Beatitudes is. And each one of them highlights a different quality. Each one of the Beatitudes highlights a different quality that we, as followers of Jesus, are to be exhibiting, to be highlighting, to be reflecting in the world. And these qualities are compassion, gentleness, righteousness, mercifulness, and peacemakers. When you read through each of the Beatitudes, those are the Beatitudes that we are to be reflecting in the world. And so what does this have to do with All Saints Day? Well, All Saints Day is a day when we pause, we recognize, and we remember all of those those who have gone before us, all who have walked this path before we were here, all the ways that they lived, the ways that they influenced, the ways that they changed and blessed, reflected God's love in the world, blessed the lives of those who knew them. It's a time for us to take pause from our everyday life and to remember those that we loved, those that we knew, those whose lives have come to an end, and yet their effect, their influence continues on in our lives and the world that we live in. Their effect, their influence continues on. It has not ended. And when in the scripture, it talks about how we're surrounded by this communion of saints. It's in the book of Hebrews that we're surrounded by this faithful people who have lived before us. It's called this cloud of witnesses. And the way it's sort of written in Hebrews, it's like a big stadium. It's like a great big stadium, like picture an Olympic stadium. And we're on the field. We're the ones that are in the game. We're currently active. We're currently running the race. We're currently the ones that are here, present on the earth, doing the thing. But the stands are filled with this cloud of witnesses. Those who have gone before us, those who are yet to come, those who are supporting us and encouraging us and cheering for us as they see us run the race. This is what Hebrews says. So since we stand surrounded by all those who have gone before, an enormous cloud of witnesses, let us drop every extra weight, everything that clings to us, everything that slows us down, and let us run with endurance the long race that is set before us. And as we run, we stay focused on Jesus, because he ran this race perfectly. So today is a day for thinking about all those people from our congregation, from our community, from our own personal lives who have come before us. We think of grandmothers and grandfathers. We think of mothers and fathers, aunts, uncles, sisters, brothers. Some of us carry with us memories of children, grandchildren, or great-grandchildren, friends, family, people we knew personally, closely, dearly, or someone perhaps who influenced us from afar. Maybe we never even met, but their influence carries with us. Who are those people for you? Who are the people who lived in previous generations who helped build your life as you live it today? Who helped build this congregation as it is now? Who were dedicated to passing on their faith to future generations? Let's just take a moment this morning as where we're sitting, where we're standing, where we are. Let's take some time to think about them, to really think about them, to pause, to remember them, and to offer thanksgiving for them. As you think of them, think of how they were a blessing, how they reflected God's love to the world around them and to you. And as we're thinking of them and remembering this, we remember that life isn't perfect, that we aren't perfect, and that no one needs to be perfect to have offered goodness in the world. And that goodness that was offered remains with us today.
want you to take a moment to think about you. Think about your own life. Think about how are we blessing others? How are we reflecting God's love in the world? What is the legacy that we are offering to the generations that will follow us? How do we offer goodness, righteousness, mercy, and peace to the world?
On All Saints Day, we remember and we reflect, and I encourage you to continue through the day remembering and reflecting. Remembering and reflecting on the cloud of witnesses that surround us. Some we don't know, some we have never known, but yet they are there. And they continue to encourage us in our faith, saying, we know this road, we've been on it, we're here, we're members of this body of Christ. We are one with creation and we are one with you. We are encouraging you on your journey. And so no matter where you are on your journey of life, whether you're just starting out, just getting going, or if you've lived out many of your years, this is the good news that we celebrate today. This is what we remember on All Saints Day. Amen. Let us pray. Oh God, we thank you for the gift of life and for all those who have served you well and now rest from their labors. We thank you for all the saints, remembered and forgotten, for those dear souls most precious to us. Today we give thanks for those who during the last 12 months have died and entered into your glory. We give thanks for Cecilia Millen, for Eddie Morrison, for John Hale, for Bill Stewart, for Earl Crockett, for Fred Mitchell, for Jim Hodgson, for Bert Quinn, for Robert Ferguson, for Isabel Richardson, for Byron Meisner, for A.J. Mathias, and for Lindsay Dinoon. We bless you for their life and love and rejoice for them all is well and all manner of things will be well. God of Jesus and our God, we are mindful of all those souls who have gone ahead of us. Teach us, and each 21st century disciple, no matter who we are or where we are, to follow their example to the best of our ability. To feed the poor in body and spirit, to support and comfort the mourners and the repentant, to encourage the meek to stand with them in crisis, to affirm those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, to cherish and learn from the merciful, and to be humbled by and to stand with the peacemakers. Let us clearly recognize what it means to be called children of God and to know we are to be your saints, neither by our own inclination nor our own strength, but simply by the call and the healing of Jesus. Oh God, today we also hold in prayer and hold before us the people of South Korea as they grieve the terrible tragedy and loss of Seoul. We grieve with them, we pray with them, and we hold them dearly in our hearts. God of compassion and care, we pray solemnly for those we hold in our hearts this day. Source of all light,
praise you for the wisdom of your word and the hope of your promises. With all your saints on earth and in heaven, we commit ourselves to the dawning of your new age. And we pray together as we were taught by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Our closing hymn is, Shall We Gather at the Lord? Of God, the peace of Christ, and fellowship of the Holy Spirit, now and forevermore.